there. Today I'm making a baklava, which I'm going to start with 6 eggs at room temperature. Starting my baklava with 1 cup of oil, 1 cup of yogurt, teaspoon of baking powder, 1/4 spoon of salt, and that's our ingredients. So I got 6 eggs here with a cup of vegetable oil and a cup of yogurt that I made myself. That goes in there with a teaspoon of baking powder and 1/4 spoon of salt, just to balance the sweetness. So we start just mixing this by hand. Then we start adding our flour gradually, which is all-purpose flour, 1 cup at a time. So out of here there'll be 6 round ball. They look like a little walnut size, so they're gonna be 60 of them. That makes our baklava 30 at the bottom, 30 layers in the top. So I got 2 cups of flour in here. This is our 3rd and our 4th. So just mix it well, and this is not a really tough dough, so it's a very soft dough and needs to rest about an hour once you make your little size ball. And a cookie sheet and a parchment paper, and not too close to each other. Once they rest about an hour, that's when it starts to expand our little rumbles. They rest, so you just hand work it like this. It's not much work. Then we're gonna work it on our surface here with a little bit of flour. Start making our mine with walnuts, or you can make it with raisins. So just add a little flour at our surface here and just work it a little bit more. So our dough is not too tight, so you don't need to knit it too hard. So you know the dough is combined all well, and just like that, we make it into nice soft dough. And our little plastic cutter here, just start cutting your little size bowl, and just with your fingers make them into a little walnut size bowl. Make 60 out of this dough. They're very soft texture. And just make them nice and round. Just cut them. They fairly go quick. And just eyeball them into equal sizes. Just like that. Just, we have our cookie sheet ready. Not too close. About a half an inch apart. So they have enough room to expand once they rest. You can make these also, leave them overnight to rest while you cover them with a sheet and then with a plastic cover, so once they don't dry up, they don't crust up. Here, they're half an inch apart once they rest an hour or so. All I do is cover them with a clean bag, just a kitchen plastic bag, and just put it inside and cover them tight. So this way, they don't need to be dried up, so they don't crust up on the top. And just like that, we leave them to rest. Here we have 1 cup of raisins. We are going to hydrate our raisins about an hour before we use it. So we'll put another cup, that makes 2 cups of black raisins. That's 2 cups with just a tablespoon of vanilla to give a flavor to our raisins. 1/4 cup of warm water. We just leave this to rest for an hour. These will be hydrated after they soak up all the water and the vanilla. We leave it to cover. This is gonna be our filling for our baklava. Also going to make 2 cups of chopped walnuts, not too fine. So that makes 2 cups, and our ninja chopper here. Walnuts that we're going to use in our baklava. So it's not too fine, but yet it's not too quick. Okay, so that would be our filling.